Hey everybody, welcome to another Sweet Feed and Row Hunting Resources. Well, obviously I'm not still back up in elk camp. Ended up having come down last night after that Sweet Feed that I posted. It started raining, and so I just got all my rain gear on and figured I'd wait it out. Hopefully the weather would break and then elk would start talking and we'd see what was going on. Well, weather didn't break. It just got worse and worse and worse, and just flat out got worse and worse and worse. And so I stayed up there until after dark, just again hoping that the weather would break and hoping I could hear something. Well, that didn't happen. So late last night I came down, but unfortunately where I go to get into this place, it's a real steep dirt trail that goes up the side of the mountain, and 6 hours of heavy rain turned that trail into nothing but mud. So in addition to just getting absolutely soaked to the bone and going through all my rain gear and boots and everything else, ended up taking a pretty nasty fall. I'm going to be all right. That's fine. But the bow, I need to do a little work on. I bent the bracket for the heads-up decoy. Actually ended up actually bending the stabilizer as well and took a chunk out of the end of my bow, and I need to check my sights, as it almost looks like the as hard as it sounds, a spot hog makes one heck of a sight. It almost looks like that got bent, so I need to do some checking on my bow and make sure that's everything's good to go, and go from there. But next couple days is just supposed to pour up there. I mean, all last night it rained. This morning it was still raining. Everything was so socked in, you couldn't see anything anyway. So I'm going to wait until the weather breaks and then get back up there. Hopefully it breaks. The weather service is saying this weekend it's supposed to break a little bit and turn nice again early next week. If that's the case, the elk should start going crazy. I would think right if that weather breaks is oftentimes a great, great time to be out in the field. So if you're up there slugging through the rain, good luck. I know it's tough, and a lot of times the elk aren't talking much, so just kind of slug it out, and a couple days, hopefully the weather will break. But if you're debating on whether to go up there now or wait, if you're like me, I'm going to wait. I'm going to take care of my bow. I'm going to get my stuff dried out again, and I'm going to wait till the weather breaks and see if we can get up there and get on some elk. The good news is from yesterday, though, is there are elk, at least in my area. There's not a lot. So I doubt I'm going to hear much talking. I doubt I'm going to get in a lot of activity, but I know the elk are there. Not only the ones that were hitting that wallow I was sitting on, but when I headed out that night, I ended up bumping into some elk that were out feeding. The unfortunate thing was, the thing that kind of worries me is, these things, I mean, in the pitch black, weren't out in the open meadows feeding. They were actually still in the thick aspens, in the cover feeding. So I have a feeling the muzzleloader hunters that were in there and the previous archery hunters may have boogered them quite a bit. So that's going to be something I'm going to have to check when I go back up in there and just see how spooky these animals are, because if they're really, really spooky, it might be tough. I mean, they're there, which is good, but so we'll see. But anyway, that's the update for today. I wish I had better news for you, but that's what it is, so take care of the bow, get her fixed, and get her running again, and we'll get back up there here in a couple days. So, good luck.